State Senator Jeremy Nordquist just got back in the States yesterday after spending a week in Israel. KETV News Watch 7's Melissa Homan spoke with the senator today and joins us live. Melissa.
Hi, Adrian. Senator Nordquist found out in June he'd be traveling with Project Interchange to Israel. The trip was sponsored by the American Jewish Committee and supposed to be a discussion of security issues with leaders in Israel and Palestine. But the group of government and business leaders found itself near the most violent attacks there in years.
As images of air attacks come out of Israel and Gaza Monday, Nebraska State Senator Jeremy Nordquist reflects on his own experiences in the Middle East.
We heard the sirens go off in Jerusalem, the air raid sirens, which were the first time that those sirens had gone off since the Gulf War.
On his first day back, Nordquist describes his week-long visit and shares his own images with KETV News Watch 7. This one shows tear gas shot at a checkpoint between Israel and Palestine.
I would say that it's certainly much more than an eye-opening trip. I would say that it's a life-changing trip.
At times, Nordquist feared for his safety, a reality for citizens of Israel every day.
Talking to the people there, they all feel concerned, but they realize that it's the situation that they live with, and if they stop, if they don't move forward, the terrorists will have won.
Nordquist says after months of missiles streaming into Israel, its attacks on Gaza were warranted.
It really instills with me the understanding for the need for every country to be able to defend itself no matter what.
He adds a lack of open media and generations of hate limit the possibility of peace. And although discouraging, peace continues to be the ultimate goal.
Even with those challenges, I think there's no doubt that for the future of the region and the world, we have to continue to push forward and try to find a way to make that happen.
Now, Senator Nordquist says U.S. interests in the Middle East are more than just oil. He says many multinational corporations have innovation centers in Israel, including Microsoft, Intel, and Google. Now, I asked him if he still would have gone knowing the violence was about to break out. He says now he wouldn't trade that experience for anything, but he probably would have postponed the trip. Adrian.
All right. Thanks, Melissa.